hope. He had to believe in hope. He had to believe that things was going to change. Okay, so let me give you an analogy that freed me some years ago. The Lord spoke to me and told me about this hope against hope. He says, they hope you don't, you hope you will. Y'all missed that, didn't you? Woo! They hope you don't come through, Delphine. You better hope you will, girl. Oh, Lord, have mercy. They hope you don't get it. And that they don't approve you for it. You better hope you will. That's hoping against hope. Your critics hope you don't make it. Your critics hope it don't happen for you. Your critics, oh, God, Jesus Christ. Your critics hope it don't sell. Oh, God, help me, please. That's hope against hope. Every day, I live my life hoping against hope because I know I got some jokers out there that hope I don't make it, but I hope I do. You better hear what I'm saying to you. That's what Abraham had to do. The hope inside of him, he saw the circumstances that were surrounding him and what he was dealing with. He saw his own wife laugh in the tent when the word came, so that he had to hope against hope. Sarah saying, man, please, ain't no way you can do nothing. You know you shooting blanks. Ain't nothing you can do, boy. He had to hope against hope. You understand what I'm saying? He had to hope against hope. They said, I hope she don't make it. I hope you do make it, baby. I sure do. They said, I hope she don't get it. Well, I hope you do get it, baby. That's what you call hoping against hope. I'll let y'all have that one. I let y'all have that one. That's one of my secrets right there. That's one of my secrets. Every time I find a joker that's got something to say about me, I you know what I'm saying? That's when I start hoping against their hope. Every time I hear about a critic that don't like Delphine, that's got something to say about me, that's what I do. I hope against their hope. That's what I do. I hope against their hope. When they say, you know, such and such, you know, with your food truck, they talking negative about your food truck. Well, automatically, I know they hoping it fail. Well, guess what? I'm hoping it don't. So that's how I hope against hope. Y'all better learn how to hope against hope. I'm trying to tell you, you better learn how to hope against hope. When you find out that they talking against you, I hope she don't get it. I hope she do. I done told y'all a secret. I just exposed a secret to y'all. I just told y'all because I promised to God on my life that's how I live. If I find out a joker is against me, not pulling for me, that means I know they hoping negative against me. Well, I start hoping against their hope. I start hoping against their hope. But this is the thing about it. You got to make sure that you got the right spirit when you're doing it. You can't do it from a retaliation stance. When the Lord reveals to you about the people that don't want to see you win, you can't become bitter. You can't become bitter. Please catch the wisdom in what I'm sharing with y'all. You cannot become bitter. You can't hope against hope from a bitter standpoint. Your hope against hope has to come from a righteous place because that's the only way God channels. God channels himself through righteousness. He does not channel himself through wrong. He don't. So you can't get fighting mad with them and want to whoop them and that kind of stuff like that, but yet say that you're hoping against hope, because what literally has happened is you've now become angry and sinning. You literally fell in their trap is what you've done. That's what you've done. You literally put yourself in their trap and fell into the hole that they're setting up for you. Because, see, what they're hoping against is what God wants to do for you. They're hoping against a blessing that has come open for you that you don't have room enough to receive. Because, see, a lot of times people see what you don't see. They see your destiny when you just trying to see today. They already see your next year. You just trying to make it today. day, and they saying, I see that girl going on TV. I don't care what nobody say. That girl going somewhere. I'm telling you, that girl, that Delphine Lee, that chick gonna blow up. You hear me? I'm telling you, she's going to be discovered. Somebody gonna hear her, and a door is gonna open for her, and she gonna be gone. Well, all I'm doing is sitting in front of 15 people right now that's sitting on the live. That's all I'm doing right now, and that's what I'm looking at. My view is saying 15, but there's some joker that looks at me and sees 15,000 people. And so if they don't like you and they see what you're doing and they say, I hope she don't. Well, I hope she do. But you got to have the right heart about it. When the Lord reveals it to you, you can't become angry. You can't become bitter against him, because you will pull yourself out of the position of the ascension that is coming to you. Abram at the time had to stay in a position as to where he did not pull himself out of that place in spite of what happened. Now, you got to understand, it was said that this word was given to him when he was maybe 40, 50 years old or so. And it did not come to pass for years. Different people say different things, you know. However it was, it didn't happen overnight. So in the midst of that going on with him, you can just imagine that if he told some people, hey, the Lord told me that I'm going to be the father of many nations, that they laughed at him because they didn't see it happen right then. Because that's the mentality that we have as people. If we don't see something happen right then, we tend to think the person is crazy because it did not manifest itself right then. But God has an appointed time. I done told y'all I love the Bible. It says when the fullness of time had come, when the fullness of time and at the appointed time, God sent his son. So there is a timing for everything. So while you are hoping against hope, there is a period of time, a diameter of time that is put there, and you have to remain consistent in your hope against hope, because it's going to happen. If you maintain your hope is nothing but your faith being built. That's all your hope is, your faith being built. So you've got to make sure that in that time now, while you're hoping against hope, you're going to see people that you're going to sometime freak you out, be like, dang, I thought she was for me. Her too? Are you serious? Not her. Lord, have mercy. Jesus Christ. Because see, it didn't happen at a time that she thought that it would have happened. Maybe when you said it, she thought you were saying that it was going to happen right away. And so it didn't happen right away. And stuff started looking like it wasn't going to ever happen for you. So you had to find out the truth about her, that she really wasn't hoping with you for real. She wasn't hoping with you. She was pretty much like Job friends. She was just hanging around as long as everything was good. She wasn't really hoping with you. See, let me get out of here, y'all. Yeah, I got to get out of here. Boy, I'm dropping nuggets like it's hot, ain't I? Jesus Christ. I'm dropping nuggets like it's hot tonight, Lisa. So you had to find out that she wasn't really a ride or die. So you had to hope against her hope. You had to hope against her hope. Yeah. Oh, it's very possible for you to think that you know the people that are hoping for you. It's very possible for you to be wrong. That they really don't be hoping for you. They really don't. You know, they really don't. It takes a very sincere person to hope for you when it hasn't happened for them. It takes a special person to desire to see you win when they feel like they hadn't won. Now, if they are the champions, they feeling real good, and your team got to play, oh yeah, they'll root for your team to win because they done won their championship. But if their team lost, it's kind of hard. Or if they're in a fear of their team losing, it's kind of hard for them to root for yours to win. It takes a very special person, a sincere person, in order for them to do that. So a lot of times we miss it because we don't know where they really stand. We don't know where they really stand. Job thought them folk was his friends. Them folk came over there as soon as things changed for Job and started accusing Job of doing stuff wrong. Now, as long as Job was fine, they thought Job was the most righteous man. Job wasn't doing nothing wrong. But I want to interject to say this to you. That's what pissed them off about Job, and that's why they had to come and see Job in that bad state. It's because, see, people get tired of you looking like you don't ever struggle. I just helped somebody right now. They getting sick of you with your little non-struggling self. They getting tired of you because you always running around talking about how good God done been to you and how God done brought you through. But they don't understand that you talking from the place of now that wasn't always like that. You were struggling like hell just a couple of years ago. They don't get that. And so they were sick of it. It looked like Job had everything. I mean, that man had cattle. That man had it all. This man had land. This man had it all. And his friends was looking at him. And the whole entire time they was looking at him, you can't convince me that they wasn't looking at him from a wrong place. They was looking at him from a place of not having hope. I hope he failed. He make me sick every time you turn around. He make me sick. I hope he fail. Look at him. Look at him. He over there, his wife, every time you see him, you know he just bought her a new Benz, don't you? I hope he, look at that, look at that. Look at that. Look at his children. His children even got their own houses and their own wives and stuff. Got all that cattle. Job ain't heard for nothing make me sick. Because as soon as things got bad for Job and sickness hit Job, the first thing they said to him, you must be done did something. You ain't got no business. And it wasn't even about the man having done nothing that he didn't have no business. See, I'm trying to tell you about the people that can only hang around when it's beneficial. Y'all better learn your circle. I've had to learn this stuff the hard way. Y'all better learn your circle. You better know the folk that you're dealing with now. You calling these folks ride or dies, and someone waiting on you to die. You better know your circle. You better know your circle. I'll drop a joker quick. Bye. You better know your circle. I'm telling you, hope against hope. I'm whining out. I got to get out of here, y'all. I've given you some nuggets out of this world. I'm just glad to feel good today. Yo, Jesus Christ. Y'all just don't know. I'm glad to feel good today. To feel like they're faint. Thank you, God. I'm just proud of that. I am. I'm proud of that. But I've given y'all some nuggets tonight. I've told you some truths. Nothing but 100% truths. I mean, sometimes I get mad at God for making me, you know, do these lies. Because I'm always telling my secrets. I'm always telling my secrets with stuff of how I make it over. You know, how I get through tough times because I have them as well. I have them as well. Things come about, you know, with me. Stuff comes about, you know, in ministry, man, please. You don't have to have a million people to have problems in ministry. You know, I got children. Like I said, issues come about. You know, issues come about. So that's just, you know, the way it is. That's just the way it is. But I, you know, he know if I come on, I can't do nothing but tell you the truth. I can't do nothing but tell you the truth. That's all I know to give you, because it is the truth that makes us free. So that's all I know to give you. So I've given a lot of nuggets. I've told you a lot of truths tonight. But I am so serious. Make sure that when you hope against hope, when you realize, when it's brought to your attention, and I just believe that that's going to happen. I'm serious. I believe that was prophetic that the Lord had me to share that with y'all tonight about this hope against hope, because we're in a season of seeing the truth about things and the truth about people. And so you're going to see people that you thought was for you that really may not have been, may not be for you, that their hope against your hope. So you're going to hope when it comes to you and you